On behalf of the Dean and Chapter and the community of this cathedral, a warm welcome to our service of Choral Evensong. This evening we welcome again the Gundulf Consort, who are singing for us while our own choir enjoys their Easter break. We thank you for your music making with us and the leading of this service. Each and every day, this cathedral is bookended by the services of prayer. We gather our own prayers, the prayers of those who have visited throughout the day, and we offer it all to God in this traditional service of evensong. So I invite you, whether you are here in the building or joining us online, to bring your own prayers as we gather at the ending of this day.
We sit now as the choir sing from the Psalms for the ninth evening of the month, Psalm number 47, which begins on page 404 in the prayer book.
Thank you. First chapter of the book of Deuteronomy, beginning at the 19th verse. Towards the end of their 40 years in the wilderness, Moses is addressing the children of Israel and reminding them of some of what they have been through. Then, just as the Lord our God had ordered us, we set out from Horeb and went through all that great and terrible wilderness that you saw on the way to the hill country of the Amorites, until we reached Kadesh Barnea. I said to you, "You have reached the hill country of the Amorites, which the Lord our God is giving us. See, the Lord your God has given the land to you. Go up, take possession, as the Lord, the God of your ancestors, has promised. Do not fear or be dismayed." All of you came to me and said, "Let us send men ahead of us to explore the land for us and to bring back a report to us regarding the route by which we should go up and the cities we will come to." The plan seemed good to me, and I selected 12 of you, one from each tribe. They set out and went up into the hill country, and when they had reached the valley of Eshcol, they spied it out and gathered some of the land's produce, which they brought down to us. They brought back a report to us and said, "It is a good land that the Lord our God is giving us." But you were unwilling to go up. You rebelled against the command of the Lord your God. You grumbled in your tents and said, "It is because the Lord hates us that he has brought us out of the land of Egypt to hand us over to the Amorites to destroy us. Where are we headed? Our kindred have made our hearts melt by reporting, 'The people are stronger and taller than we. The cities are large and fortified up to heaven.' We actually saw there the offspring of the Anakim." I said to you, "Have no dread or fear of them. The Lord your God, who goes before you, is the one who will fight for you, just as he did for you in Egypt before your very eyes, and in the wilderness, where you saw how the Lord your God carried you, just as one carries a child, all the way that you traveled until you reached this place. But in spite of this, you have no trust in the Lord your God, who goes before you on the way to seek out a place for you to camp, in fire by night and in the cloud by day, to show you the route you should take." When the Lord heard your words, he was wrathful and swore, "Not one of these, not one of this evil generation, shall see the good land that I swore to give to your ancestors, except Caleb, son of Jephunneh. He shall see it, and to him and to his descendants I will give the land on which he set foot, because of his complete fidelity to the Lord." Even with me the Lord was angry on your account, saying, "You also shall not enter there. Joshua, son of Nun, your assistant, shall enter there. Encourage him, for he is the one who will secure Israel's possession of it. And as for your little ones, who you thought would become booty, your children, who today do not yet know right from wrong, they shall enter there. To them I will give it, and they shall take possession of it. But as for you, journey back into the wilderness in the direction of the Red Sea." Here ends the first lesson.
The second reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, the 20th chapter, beginning at the 11th verse, continuing the story of the first Easter morning. Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, Rabunai, which means teacher. Jesus said to her, Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, I have seen the Lord. And she told them that he had said these things to her. Here ends the second reading.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Thank you. we may always serve thee in pureness of living and truth. Through the merits of the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
The anthem, Ye Choirs of New Jerusalem, Your Sweetest Notes Employ, is a setting of words 1,000 years old by Saint Fulbert of Chartres. They can be found in the hymn book at number 221. The music is by Hugh Blair.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Devouring depths of hell, their prey at his command restore. As we reflect on the mystery of Jesus' rescue of the dead from the grave to new life, let us hold in our prayers all who have died recently, whether quietly and at peace, through sickness or natural disaster, or from violence and the cruelty of war. Let us pray for those whose anniversaries fall at this time, and for departed members of our own families and friends. Welcome, Lord, into your calm and peaceful kingdom, all who out of this life have departed to be with you. Grant them rest and a place with the spirits of the just, and give them the life that knows not age, the reward that passes not away, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In our daily prayers for the Anglican Communion, we pray, as always, for Archbishop Justin of Canterbury, and on this day in particular for the Diocese of Derry and Raphoe in the Church of Ireland. We pray for this Diocese of Canterbury, today for the parish of St. Mary in Castro, for all the clergy and people who serve God's mission there. And on this day, the Church commemorates the life and ministry of Dietrich Bonhoeffer, a young man who was executed at the age of 39 on this day in 1945 for his Christian witness against the Nazi regime. As we give thanks for his faith and his influential teaching, let us hold in our prayers all who at this time are held hostage, all who are prisoners of conscience, and all who at the risk of their own lives dare to speak out against cruelty and injustice. O God, whose Son forgave his enemies while he was suffering shame and death, strengthen those who suffer for the sake of conscience. When they are accused, save them from speaking in hate. When they are rejected, save them from bitterness. When they are imprisoned, save them from despair. And to us, your servants, give grace to honor their witness and to discern and uphold the truth. For his sake, who suffered for us and by whose wounds we are healed, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Let us pray for a moment in silence, bringing before God our own private prayers, those for whom we have promised to pray, our own needs and thanksgivings, sorrows and joys. And let us pray for each other and for ourselves as we say the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. evermore. Amen. After the hymn, there will be a retiring collection to support the ministry of the cathedral. Our music, mission, and the care of this great building cost £30,000 every day. So please be as generous as you can. The stewards can receive gifts of money, and you can donate by bank cards near the door. We thank you for whatever you can give. We stand now to sing the hymn, Now the Green Blade Riseth from the Buried Grain, hymn number 212.